know that feeling? Do y'all feel like 5 is impossible? I know now I think 5 is not impossible, but do any of y'all feel like 5 is impossible? Okay, thank you for being honest. I appreciate your honesty. There is one person in the room that feels the way I felt. Thank you. Thank you. Maybe it was just a South Carolina thing. I don't know. But anyway, I just felt like it was so far away, but we did it. And I was so excited. I earned an $800 commission check from the company, and I was like, this is legit. They like paid me $800. I was a college student. I was trying to earn $50 a week. So this was like on time. I like made really great money for myself. And so the next month I went into DIQ, and 12 weeks later from that career conference debuted as a sales director and had earned my car. And so you guys, what I want to tell you is the value of making a decision. It's just deciding. 1 minute I was undecided, and the next minute I was. And 3 months later I had earned a car, and 3 months after that became a sales director in the top 2% of the greatest, the company that is run by the greatest female entrepreneur in American history. Like, y'all, that's the company we're in. It's not just Mary Kay. You know what I mean? Like, this is, like, the best company. When you're a sales director, you're in the top 2% of the best company. So, like, it's a big deal. However, I've always been, like, the overachiever. I was the president of this, queen of that, you know, like, if you were going to give me a 99, really, a 0 was equivalent, like 100, perfect, or none. Well, I learned really quick that perfection does not work in Mary Kay. Can any of y'all relate? Yes. I learned the hard way because I wanted everything to be perfect, and every situation in Mary Kay was different, so I couldn't just prepare for this situation and execute. I had to know this situation and this situation, and so I had to learn to be flexible, and I had to learn that no meant next. And I had to learn that you didn't have to have a perfect body and perfect hair and perfect nails, and you didn't have to have all of these accolades and have this perfect life, and y'all know what I mean? So I walked into my first leadership conference, and I felt this big. I felt very small because all I had known in Mary Kay was success, and I was number one in my unit meeting from the first week I attended. I had the highest sales. I had the new recruits. I was in DIQ. I was a superstar. Well, all of a sudden, I was at the bottom of the scoreboard, and I was the little bitty fish in the ocean. It ain't a pond anymore, you guys. It was like the ocean. So I came home from that event, and I told my husband, he was my boyfriend at the time, now husband, I said, man, I just want to tell you, I cried the whole way home in Long Beach, California, and I just am not like those girls in my area. Like, I just don't fit. This is not, I don't know. I just walked in thinking, you know, this is just not what I'm supposed to do. It's too hard. Mary Kay's hard, you know? And so he patted my hand, and he listened so sweetly, and he said, well, I'm really sorry that you're, you know, really frustrated. And I was like, oh, thank goodness, you know, he's going to tell me, you know, you were going to be a teacher anyway, so, yeah, like, that's great. So how do you send your car back? However, the Lord must have spoke to him, because he patted my hand and said, this is my future you're messing with, and you've already earned one car, and you need to earn some more, so you better get this thing figured out, because you got a lot of work to do. I was like, okay, so let's see how this goes. So thank God for the man who said, you're going to sell what? Well, that's the dumbest idea you've ever had. And he called it Avon for my first year, but somehow, like, he came a long way. You know, with men, you show them the money and the honey, and all of a sudden, they're on board. So it's all good, right, guys? They need two things, you know? Sorry, there's children in the room. Can y'all delete that? Anyway, So after that first year, I just felt frustration of being a sales director. It just felt really hard for me because I had always been an excellence person and I had always been an achiever. But Mary Kay didn't fit in that box like study, take the test, study, take the test, make 100. So it was just different. It was business and it was women. And women are emotional and they're drama. And, you know, like we're crazy that 1 week out of the month. And like, you know, we're just like figuring all that stuff out. And I was very young and, you know, I didn't know myself, much less how to deal with all these other women. And so I just continued to exist in Mary Kay, really. And I continued to struggle as a new sales director. This felt hard for me. And we were headed to leadership conference. Troy Mayfield Banks called Get In That Cadillac, and had made another decision at a company event that I was no longer willing to hang out in the middle. Because you guys, for me, mediocrity was miserable. I was miserable in the middle. And I knew that I had been called to bigger and better things. I knew that there were a lot of people waiting on me to step up so that they could go on the career conference stage. Because when you're a Cadillac sales director, your unit gets to walk on stage. And someone said to me, some of those women may never have an opportunity to walk on a company stage unless you are willing to step up and step into your power and earn a pink Cadillac. And that was the only reason I needed. And so we finished our Cadillac in 2005, and I finally learned to start loving the girl in the mirror. I have really, really, really battled with self-worth, and I tell myself, or I tell other people that I actually, if you really think about it, it's really sad to say out loud, I guess hearing myself say it, but I really feel like for years I have emotionally abused myself. Do y'all do that? You're just never good enough, you guys. You're just never good enough. It's just never good enough. But you know, through a lot of discipleship and through a lot of prayer and a lot of reading God's word and through a lot of books and mentors, I have finally learned to love the girl in the mirror. And I'm telling you right now, when you finally can grab a hold of that, God can use you in so many big ways that you will just be amazed at how much power He has put inside of you and the amazing gifts and talents He gave you that He didn't give other people, and that all He's asked us to do is just to use the abilities we have and the abilities we were given. I'm not Tammy Lovitch. I don't have Tammy's gifts, but I'm Holly, and I have to use Holly's gifts to be the best Holly that Holly can be. And you guys, the journeys all look different. Every national that will stand on the stage and train you this weekend, every journey is different because our talents are different, our gifts are different, our children are different, our husbands are different, our houses are different, our lives are different. So be okay. If you get nothing from me this weekend, I just pray that you will learn to be okay with who you are and that you will learn to use the abilities that you have to be a great you today. Who can you impact and bless today? And so after finishing my first pink Cadillac and debuting my first offspring sales director, 4 years later I was in an IQ and made the decision, my goodness, Lord had called me to national and I was ready to go. And so 4 years later I debuted as a national sales director, and I'm telling you what, the suit is so much more fabulous at this stage too, by the way. Love my national suit, but I love